never been there. They've never been there. But the Prophet ﷺ says, well, I swear by Allah, controls the soul of Muhammad, that the one of them knows exactly where his house in Al-Jannah better than he knew it in the dunya. Before he enters. It's not like he walks in, you know, when you go to a new place. I mean, even today, I've been living where I live for 2 years. And today, I made the wrong turn. In the complex, I made the wrong turn. You go to a new place or another country, whatever, just you're lost. Every move you need to make, you have to ask. Doesn't matter how many maps you got, doesn't matter, navigators, all that. iPhones, all these good stuff. You still ask. But here, الجنة يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فوالذي نفس محمد بيده لا أحدهم أهدى بمنزله في الجنة من منزله كان في الدنيا. The one of them knows where exactly his place in الجنة better than he knew it in the dunya. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us that. Also one of the things that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned on the day of judgment is the people who will enter al-Jannah. And there is a group of people that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned specifically. And it's very important to have a talk about that. And very important to reflect on it. Because those people who enter al-Jannah that the Prophet ﷺ had mentioned in this hadith, they enter al-Jannah because of a character. And as we have talked about the reckoning and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold people accountable. And as we had spoken about people receiving their book in their right hand and people receive their books in their left hand, they are people who don't receive their books because they are straight into Jannah. They're straight into paradise. There is no reckoning, there is no qisas, nothing. They will be admitted straight into Jannah. It's very important for us to know who those are. And as we said before, so we can try to be of them and we can belong to them and to this group. So very important that we understand why the Prophet ﷺ mentioned them and to know their characters. Perhaps we can try to be like them. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and listen to this very soft hadith. And this hadith, الرقراق, as they call it, that should soften the hearts. سألت ربي عز وجل فوعدني أن يدخل الجنة من أمتي 70,000 تضيء وجوههم إضاءة القمر ليلة البدر. فاستزدت ربي فزادني مع كل ألف 70,000. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something. So he promised me, Subhanallah promised the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that he will admit 70,000 people from his ummah, from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that they will be admitted into al-Jannah. تُضِيءُ وُجُوهَهُمْ إِضَاءَةً لَيْلَةَ الْبَدْرِ. Their faces are so bright when they enter al-Jannah, like the brightness of al-Badr, of the moon, full moon. The night of 14, 15, full moon. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, then I asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for more. I asked Allah for more. Muhammad ﷺ, Khalilullah. Muhammad ﷺ, Habibullah. Muhammad ﷺ, Rasulullah. When Allah addresses the prophets in the Quran with their names, يا موسى يا عيسى قال الله يا عيسى يا موسى يا إبراهيم all these قال إبراهيم he addressed محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رسول الله يا نبي الله محمد رسول الله. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked Allah سبحانه وتعالى to give him more than the 70,000. This ummah is huge. فقال الله عز وجل مع كل ألف 70,000. So Allah gave him more with every 1,000 of the first 70,000, another 70,000. And you do the math. You do the math. The point is, it's not how big the number is. Because Muslims are a lot. The point is to try to be amongst them. To try to know them. To try to know why those people were blessed. So maybe I can try to be like them. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, ثُمَّ يَحْثِي رَبِّي بِكَفَّيْهِ ثَلَاثَ حَثَوَانَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grab three handfuls of people into al-Jannah over that. فَقَالَ عُمَرْ اللَّهُ أَكْبَرْ كَبَّرَ عُمَرْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala control the heavens and the earth, the hearts of the people between two of the fingers of Allah. قَلِّبُهُمَا كَيْفَ يَشَاء وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. So Umar then said, Allahu Akbar. Because the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله بن عمر يقول إن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قرأ يوما قول الله تعالى عن إبراهيم ربي إنهن أضللن كثيرا من الناس فمن تبعني فإنه مني ومن عصاني فإنك غفور رحيم. وقرأ الحبيب قبل الله حكاية عن عيسى إن تعذبهم فإنهم عبادك وإن تغفر لهم فإنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. فرفع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يديه إلى السماء وبكى وقال اللهم أمتي 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 أمتي. فقال الله لجبريل يا جبريل انزل على محمد وسل ما يبكيك والله أعلم. فنزل جبريل فقال ما يبكيك يا رسول الله؟ فقال أمتي أمتي يا جبريل. فقال الله لجبريل مرة يا جبريل اذهب إلى محمد فقل له إنا سنرضيك في أمتك ولا نسوك. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم recited those two آيات in صحيح مسلم. One talks about Ibrahim عليه السلام talking about his people, and one talks about عيسى عليه السلام talking about his people and asking for forgiveness for them. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم raised his hands to the heavens and he cried صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he made dua and saying, O Allah, my ummah, my ummah. O Allah, my people, my people. That is the merciful Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All he wanted from this dunya is to save you from the hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Jibreel, go to him, go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and ask him why he cries. So Jibreel goes down to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asks him, why you cry? So he said, Ummati, Ummati, ya Jibreel, my people. And Allah knows why he cries. My people. So when Jibreel goes back to Allah and asks him and tells him, then Allah tells him, go back to him and tell him, we will satisfy you regarding your ummah. And you will be happy. And you will not be upset. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he will take care of his ummah the way he wants. And you know what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants for his ummah. He wants all of them in Jannah. All of them. And they will be, inshallah, those who die in Tawheed. Going back to the hadith, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث ابن عباس عرضت علي الأمم فرأيت النبي ومعه الرهط وفي رواية ومعه الرهيط ورأيت النبي ومعه الرجل والرجلان ورأيت النبي وليس معه أحد إذ رفع لي سواد عظيم فظننت أنهم أمتي فقيل لي هذا موسى وقوم ولكن انظر إلى الأفق يقول فنظرت فإذا سواد عظيم ثم قيل لي انظر إلى الأفق الآخر فنظرت فإذا سواد عظيم فقيل لي هذه أمتك ومعهم 70,000 يدخلون الجنة بغير حساب ولا عذاب. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in this authentic hadith that the umam were shown to me. And some of the riwayat said that this happened on the night of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ascended to the heavens. So he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the people and the nations were presented to me. So I would see the Prophet and he has with him al-Rahf or al-Ruhayl. And that is 10 people or less. All